Practicing catch and release with cutthroat trout or catching your limit of walleye may be the fashion with a lot of anglers today, but catching shovelnose sturgeon, now that's old school. They're a throwback to the dinosaur age, believed to date back over 200 million years. But native populations still exist in Wyoming, and recently fisheries biologists with the Wyoming Game and Fish Department took to the Bighorn River near Greybull to learn more about where reintroduced sturgeon here are spawning, and use the data to determine future fish stocking strategies. Cody fisheries biologist Joe Skorupski says placing radio transmitters in sturgeon helps biologists learn where the fish are spawning.
What we're doing is placing them in the fish, tracking them to where they are potentially spawning right around the end of June, seeing whether or not they are truly spawning, whether they have flowing milk or eggs. And then we will continue to track them to see if they're holding in that area, which is all indications that they are spawning in the area. And then we'll seasonally look for those fish, you know, we'll come back in the fall and then again the following year.
Sturgeons migrate in the spring from lower parts of the river upstream to spawn. Embryos from the eggs then drift downstream until they're developed enough to swim. Biologists want to know if those embryos have enough drift time before river flows take them into Bighorn Reservoir, where they probably won't survive due to lack of adequate oxygen in the reservoir's deep areas. Sturgeon are rare in Wyoming. It's considered a species of greatest conservation need. But efforts began back in 1996 to create a self-sustaining population of sturgeon in the Bighorn River, while also creating a unique sport fishing opportunity for anglers.
This is an opportunity to get another species in the river. It's really unique. They're fun to catch. They're definitely can get to a pretty large size. The largest was caught out of the Bighorn River, which is just over 10 pounds.
Over the years, nearly 600,000 fingerling and fry sturgeons have been stocked in the Bighorn River. Shovelnose sturgeon is distinguished by the obvious flat, shovel-shaped snout and by its bony plates called scutes. The whisker-like barbs next to its mouth act as sensors on the river bottom to identify prey. The sucker-type mouth sucks up the prey, usually aquatic invertebrates. The transmitters last about 4 years and should provide biologists with the first steps to determine what level of stocking is needed and perhaps one day bring this fish species into fashion with anglers. This is Ray Hageman with the Wyoming Game and Fish Department.
Sweet.